Very good morning, children. Welcome to the online class. From today onwards, we will be starting with our topics, correct? And the thing is, that is on next week, Friday, I think so. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, all the 3 days, you will be having your test. That is the first round test. Okay, 12th, 13th and 14th, you will be having 3 days test. Per day, two subject tests will be there. So please do prepare well and attend the test, okay? And now, do not worry about the portions. I'll complete the portions. How much ever it has been completed, that much only I'll be giving for your test. Do not worry about that. And the notes will be uploaded and there will be no issues regarding the notes and the topic, everything. How much ever we get, we'll complete by the next week. We are going to write the test based on now. Then, what is the topic today we are talking about? What do you think? Why are vehicles, when you are going to park your vehicle, if you have a vehicle, okay? Now, you want to go somewhere. What will you do? Will you take the vehicle and move? Yes, but initially the vehicle was in your home. Now you need to go to your friend's house. Then from your home to the friend's house, the vehicle is in movement. It is in movement, correct? What is that movement called as? What is that called as? Now if I'm moving from one end to the another end, okay, what is this called as? What is this movement called as? This movement is called as motion. Why is it called as motion? Because there is a change in position of an object from a particular time. Now, I was standing initially near the board itself. Now I'm traveling from one point of the board to the another point of the board. Correct? Almost I need 3 to 4 seconds of time to move from that corner to the this corner of a board. Correct? Almost maximum 5 seconds I require to move from that corner to this corner. Now if there is any movement of an object with respect to time, time is very important, children. If there is a movement of an object with respect to time, such a movement is called as motion. What is it called as? It is a motion. That is the movement of an object with respect to time from one point to the another is called as motion. On today's class, we are going to start with our new topic, that is motion. What did we define the motion as? The motion, an object is said to be in the movement. If an object, or you can say it as an object is in the motion when it is moving from one point to the another point with respect to time, or change in position of an object from one point to the another point with respect to time. You can define, but there should be a one particular word where it should have in the definition. You can put is or than, that extra things, but the thing, what is the main thing, is change in position with respect to time. If you have this wording, that is motion is change in position, motion is change in position with respect to time. What does mean change? What are you going to change the position? You are going to change the position of an object. That is change in position of an object. The thing is, of an object with respect to time is called as motion. Then what is there? What is the definition given in your textbook? An object is said to be in motion when its position changes with respect to time. When its position changes with respect to time, that is what we written. Change in position of an object with respect to time. Simple wordings make your sentence meaningful. Okay? It is not that the definition should be ditto as the textbook. If it is math, then the theorem should be written as it is. Correct? If it is math, the theorem should be written as it is. But in the definition of your science, English, social, whatever the things you are, Kannada, whatever you take, rather than the math subject, the definition, the main word, what you want it to be there, if it is there and extra is that or this, if it has been added also, it is not a problem. But make sure the main words are there. Let us change in position of an object with respect to time. You can note down this definition, or if you want, the notes is already ready for you. It will be given. If you want that definition only, you can learn. It is your choice, children. Okay? Now, I need to give an example to this, correct? I cannot define it simply like that. I need to give a example for this definition. What is that definition? I'll take a car. Movement of a car, correct? Now, if you are standing in front, if you are standing in your home, and that is in a balcony, okay? In your home, the balcony will be there, you will be standing there. You will see the movement of a car. Okay, initially when you were saying it was near your home, now it has come to the road corner. There is a movement. Yes. What is the time it required to move from your home to the road corner? It is almost 5 seconds or 10 seconds also, or it might take 1 minute. Yes. So it is change in motion with respect to time. Time is very important, and the object, this position should be changed. Now, if I'm standing here itself for 1 hour, okay, if I'm standing here itself for 1 hour, can you say this is a motion? No. Why? I'm not moving. If I'm moving only, I can say I am in motion or I'm in movement. If I'm not there, if I'm not in the movement, if I'm not moving from one place to another, then it is not called as a motion. Dear children, they'll ask us. The car was standing in front of a house, or I may also ask. Initially the car was in front of the house. Now it has been moved to the road corner. Is there any movement? Yes, it is. The car has been moved. If the car has been standing for 1 hour in front of your home itself, is there any motion? No. Why it has been? Yeah, there I have mentioned the time. 1 hour in the ille ninti the car, but it is not in the motion. Or it is not in the moment, then it is not a motion. Did you understand? Are you getting what is motion? That is, if you have an object, it is not a non-living thing only. If it is a living thing, that is, if me, if I myself move from that corner to this corner only, I might tell you if there is a motion in me or there is a moment in me where I am moving from that corner to this corner. If I am not moving, if I am still here itself, I cannot say there is a motion in my body or there is a movement in my body where for 1 hour. Did you understand? So what is the example? What is the example? Movement of a car. Correct? Movement of a car. Now, after the movement of car, only the car moves? Only the car moves? No. If you open the tap, what happens? If you open the tap in your home, what happens? The water comes out of the tap, correct? Where was the water initially? Where was the water initially? Inside the tap. When you on it, where is the water now? It has been filled by a bucket or it has been filled by a tumbler, correct? Correct? Initially, it was inside the tap. It was not on the tap. It was inside the tap. Now, when you on the tap, when you turn on the tap, it has been drop down to the bucket or a tumbler where it is being filled. So is there a movement? Do you find any movement there? Yes, before it was inside, now it is outside. Inside, outside, there is more difference. Correct? So there also you can find a motion. That is an object. What is the object? Water. Water is an object. Correct? So water is being flown out from the tap to the bucket. So there is a motion. There is a movement of water from one place to the another. Correct? Then, early morning, what you people will do when you want to maintain your fitness, what you people will do? You will walk, you'll run, you'll do some exercises, you'll do yoga. Correct? Is there any movement in your body? Yes, when you walk, you say, Mom, I have walked for 1 kilometer every day. I'll be walking for 1 kilometer. It might take half an hour for me. So, from your home to your school, if I do not want to talk about the early morning walk only, some people will come to the school by walk, correct? So, from your home to the school, points are there, you are an object. So, how much time do you want to meet or to come to the school? It might take 20 minutes, 15 minutes, 1 hour. So, that is also a movement, that is the movement of your body, correct? Now, after that, when you are in the swimming pool also, from one end to the another end of a pool, you will be swimming to learn swim, correct? So that is also the movement. The body is moving from one pool to the another pool, correct? One end of a pool to the another end of a pool, correct? So that is also movement. When there is change in position of an object with respect to time, then it is called as motion. So I hope you people are very clear with the motion. Then after this, I'll give you another one. Is there any motion or a movement of a body in the bird? Do you find any movement of a body in the bird? I've talked about walking, running, everything. I have not talked about flying. Is there any movement of a bird? Yes? No? Why is it S? Why is it not no? Yeah? If it is S, I also tell it is S. Why? Because when the bird moves from one tree to another tree, when it moves, it does not, living monkey, jumps from one tree to another tree, one end to the another end. But the bird flies from one tree to another tree. There is a movement. Yeah, when the bird flies, that is when the bird wings is being moving, it is in motion, then it will be in different position. Okay? So, if there is any object from, if I take a book and if I keep it from one end to the another end, that is also the moment the book is being placed at the another end of the table with this much second, with this much time. So that is called as movement. Clear? Then, after this, movement along a straight line. Why do you want to learn this topic? Movement along a straight line. Now, example, if I'm staying nearby, okay? If I'm staying nearby Ayodhya Sagar, where the hotel is nearby, correct? Nearby to the school. If I'm staying there, I'll not stay inside the hotel. It might somewhere nearby the hotel. So if I come to the straight, how will be my direction? It will be a straight line, correct? It will be a straight line. If I am very inside to that road of Ayodhya Sagar, very inside of that road of Ayodhya Sagar, then how is my movement to the school? It will be in a curve way, correct? So now the thing is, what is the difference? What happens when the motion is in the straight line, when it is in the curved line, we'll be seeing in today's class. Before that, I wanted to tell you about the vector quantity and scalar quantity. Okay, before going to the distance, displacement, motion in a straight line, everything, I wanted to tell you about the scalar quantity and vector quantity. What is the scalar? What is this vector? So the scalar is a quantity which has only magnitude and no direction. Direction in hing bandri and an important alla, but I want you to meet to that point. So example I'll give you. The thing is, we are going to talk about the scalar quantity. What is this? Only magnitude, no direction. Now, I told you, when I'm staying near the Ayodhya Sagar, I'll come very straight to the school where I do not have any curve or when I do not have any turns to be taken. Okay, now, what happens? What does this scalar quantity mean? Now, from the school to my home, it is 1 kilometer. Let us assume from the school to your home itself, it is 1 kilometer. It is your wish. If you want, you can come in a straight line. If you want, you can come in the cross, straight road. If you want, you can make a shortcut road and come. It is your choice. But at what distance you are going to come? At what distance you are going to come? That is the magnitude. I do not want direction. In Hingaluba, straight Agaluba, Hingaluba. Okay, but I want you to meet to that point. But you, what your mother's is, go in whichever way you want, but I want you to go to the school on time. Correct? So that is scalar. I do not want which direction is that moving, but I wanted to meet at that particular point. So that is scalar. So what is this? Measuring your mass. Correct? Measuring your mass. If I take a sugar or grain, that is the rice, ragi, Wheat, if I take, will you say the rice to stand very straight? Will you say some grains will be sleeping and some grains will be in slant side? Yes, in that packet of flour when you go to the grocery shop, and if you take that, all the grains will not be standing straight. As you measure your body weight, they say please do stand straight. If you kneel down or if you tilt, the body weight might go miss. Correct, it won't stand straight. I do not want the direction, is it straight or not, but I want the mass. Kg there. Correct? Yes, will you agree with that? Then time. Then time. Okay? Now, if with respect to time, what shall I say? I won't take that clockwise and anti-clockwise of direction of a clock. I do not want that. So what will you do? If you are using your watch almost after a week, okay? Now, some people will do what they'll do if I'm not using the watch. It will be your guess, okay? If you have a watch of made up of shell, if you want to put a shell to the watch, okay, then the solar watches will also be there. If the watch is running by a shell, then what or a battery, what you will do, what all some other people will do, they will use it when they require and they'll open the shell, that is the open the click, so that the clock won't work. Okay, then now yesterday, for example, yesterday I was wearing a watch. When I came back to the home, it was 10 o'clock. Okay, now I've turned it off. I've opened the click so that the watch does not work. Now I wanted to wear the watch today. Okay, at what time I wanted to wear it? It was at 8 o'clock. Now, will you turn the watch to the anti-clockwise direction or a clockwise direction? If you go to the clockwise direction, it takes time. Why? Because 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then 8. So much of running. If I go it with the anti-clockwise direction, it reaches by 2 hours only, it reaches 8. Correct? So what I require it to be in 8 o'clock. I do not want in whichever direction it is. It is your wish. In anti-clockwise अलग तरफ से, clockwise अलग तरफ से. But I want it to be in 8 o'clock. So this is the scalar quantity. This is the scalar quantity. Okay? Then it is not like that. If I'm moving from one place, or if you are going from your home to the school, clock उल्टा मार्बे को, not in that direction, not in that way I'm telling, but I'm giving an example where the scalar quantity meant by the time. Okay, then distance. Distance as usual, we won't say that you need to go in this direction itself. Okay, talapada sako. So that is distance. So what are the examples? I'll take mass as I've given the example for the grains. Then I'll take time where if the watch is being stopped and if you are wanted to run the watch, you will make the way easier. Correct. If the watch has been stopped at 10 o'clock, if I want to make it 6 o'clock, I'll come back. I won't go in the normal direction where the watch runs because it takes a long time. So then I'll come about distance. Distance. We'll talk about the distance. Distance, I've given you the brief thing that I do not want you to go in this particular direction itself, but I want you to go to the school on time. So that is the thing what your mom says. Correct. Nan friend kete hokti namma late aga. I do not want any reasons, but I want you to go to the school on time. Wherever, with whomever you want, you can go. But I want you to go to the school on time. So that is distance. I do not want which direction you have to choose, but I want you to go to the school. So these are the example for scalar quantity. Then what is vector quantity? What is this vector quantity? It has magnitude as well as the direction. Magnitude and direction. Magnitude and direction. What is this? What all comes in magnitude? What all comes in direction? We'll talk about it. Now, force. Force. Now, if you want to push me, okay, if you want to push me back, ನೀವು ನನ್ನ ಹಿಂದೆ ತಳ್ಳಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ವೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಯು ಪುಷ್ ಮೀ ಯುಲ್ ಪುಷ್ ಮೀ ಇನ್ ಫ್ರಂಟ್ ಯಾ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಪುಷ್ ಮೀ ಇನ್ ಫ್ರಂಟ್ ಸೋ ದಟ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಫಾಲ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಓಕೆ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಮೀ ಟು ಫಾಲ್ ಫ್ರಂಟ್ ವೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಯು ಪುಷ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಪುಷ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೈಡ್ ಸೈಡಿಂದ ಬಂದು ನನ್ನ ತಡೆದ್ರೆ ನನ್ನ ಮುಂದೆ ಬೀಳ್ತೀನಾ? ನೋ, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೈಡ್, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಫಾಲ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಸೈಡ್. ವೆನ್ ಯು ಪುಷ್ ಮಿ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಫಾಲ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್, ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್? ಇಫ್ ಯು ಪುಷ್ ಮಿ ಅ ಸೈಡ್, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಅದರ್ ಸೈಡ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಪುಷ್ ಮಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಸೈಡ್, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಫಾಲಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ರೈಟ್ ಸೈಡ್. ಸೊ ದ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬೀನ್, ದ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬೀನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಮಿ ಟು ಫಾಲ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ಪುಷಿಂಗ್ ಮಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಮಿ ಟು ಫಾಲ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಪುಷಿಂಗ್ ಮಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್. ಸೊ ವೇರ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಯು ಆರ್ ಪುಷಿಂಗ್. If you push me from the side, that is from the right hand side, I won't fall friend. Correct? Will you agree with that? Yes. If I want to throw the chalk to you, I cannot throw the chalk from that side. It won't fall on you. Correct? If I want to throw it for your side, I need to throw it straight itself. It falls on you. Alva, is it true? So force. Force is a vector quantity. Why? Direction is very important and the magnitude. Magnitude. Force. Newton. It's already magnitude, it's already done, but direction is very important, correct? So force, then what else? Displacement. Can I say displacement is an example for the force? How can you say, ma'am, displacement is an example for force? I'll give you an example now. Let me take the distance example itself. What did I tell you? Distance from your home to the school was the distance example. Correct. Now, your mother asked you that if you go straight from the home, correct, without taking any turn to the road or without meeting your friend, if you go straight from your home to the school, you reach the school very fast. That if your home is 1 kilometer away from the school, it is a straight road, then you will be reaching the school very fast with less amount of time. That is a straight road. If you say, yeah, mom, no, mom, I want to go with my friends itself, it might take almost, when you go straight, it might take 20 minutes. If you want to meet your friends and then go along with your friend, it might take 45 minutes. So that is the displacement. How much long, how much direct, how much whichever direction you say, ma, I'll go right and then left, then another one Satish will be coming, and then I'll go to the Smita's house and I'll take Smita, and then I'll go to the Mamta's house and I'll take Mamta, and then I'll go home and then I'll go to the school. It almost take 45 minutes to take everybody and then go. So distance is long. When the distance and the direction is long, then the time data is called as displacement. Yes, will you agree with that? The distance is long. Will you agree with that? When you come straight direction, only 20 minutes. When you want to meet all your friends and then come to the school, it takes 45 minutes or 1 hour. Might be. I do not know the exact one. Can I say that there's a displacement where you are going to stop from one point to another point and then move? Yeah, I cannot say that there's a distance. Distance is a total thing what you have traveled. Displacement is not a total. The point where you are going to stop. I'll define you the displacement and the distance. Do not worry about that. But understand what is vector quantity. Vector quantity is which direction you are taking. When the road is very easy to your school, why do you want to take a long road and then come to the school? Correct. Longest road and the shortest road. That is the direction. That is the displacement. Correct? Will you agree with that? When you are going to talk about the magnitude and the, you know, magnitude is one point to another point, yeshto to deko. What is the time you require? What is the mass it is? Correct? But displacement is what, or the vector quantity is what, in which direction you are going to take that. That is displacement or the vector quantity. Yeah, well, do you have any doubts regarding the scalar and the vector quantity? I hope you do not have any doubts because it is clear for you, the topic. If you have any doubts, you can come and ask. That is not an issue. But this scalar quantity is only the magnitude. Yes, kg ide, yes, time beku, yellinda yelligode, ashte. That is scalar. But vector is not that. Vector is not that. Force, yav direction apply maartidya. And Munde will be a Hindi in the apply. When I wanted to fall back, you need to apply the force on friend. If you apply me the friend force, I can fall back. Correct? And if I talk about the displacement, I do not want to talk about the school. It might take a long thing to understand. For example, if your mom says you to go to the grocery shop and get 1 kg of sugar, okay, you might take a long distance and then go and then come back. Your mom, the shop is very nearby to your home. It might take only 5 minutes to go and come, but you won't take 5 minutes. You will talk to all your friends and then go buy sugar and then come back. So that is displacement, where you are going to take a long direction to meet from one point to the another point. That is the longest direction. Direction is very important. What is the magnitude? The magnitude is you are getting the sugar. Correct? You are getting the sugar of what kgs? 1 kg. That is the magnitude. Understood? So direction and the direction and the magnitude is for vector quantity, and only the magnitude, that is only the kg time, that is what? It is the scalar quantity. I hope it is clear for you. Then coming to the topic, that is motion in a straight line. What is this motion in a straight line? If you understand the scalar quantity and vector quantity, if I tell you motion in a straight line, what does it mean? Motion in a straight line. So here there is a movement of an object from one point to another point, but it is also saying that it is in a straight line. So you are going to talk about two points here. That is distance as well as the displacement. Why are you going to talk about the distance as well as displacement? Movement of an object. So there is a movement of an object along a straight line. They have given a direction. So displacement also comes there. Artha aagtadiya? So motion in a straight line, motion of an object in a straight line. Motion along a straight line. Okay. Now, motion is what? Change in position of an object with respect to time. So, motion is a distance. Along a straight line is a displacement. So, here you are going to talk about distance as well as the displacement. Okay? Distance as well as the displacement. What is this? When you have an object moving along a straight line, the motion of an object is called a rectilinear. Now, okay, fine. Before defining the rectilinear motion, let me come to this statement. That is motion along a straight line. If you are moving in a straight line, what is that called? What is the type of motion is called as? If you are moving in a circular time, it is a circular motion. Correct? If you are, if the sound is moving in a wave, or if you find if you go to the lake and all, sea, if you go to sea, there you find wave. So you tell that is the wave motion. Why? Because the water is coming from one end to the another end in the form of a wave. So it is a wave motion. When you are moving in a straight line, then it is called as a rectilinear motion. Then it is called as a rectilinear motion. Correct? What is this rectilinear motion? The motion of an object in along a straight line. The movement of an object along a straight line. If you are not using the word motion, you can use movement of an object. Movement of an object along a straight line is called as a rectilinear motion. Clear? Now, since we are talking about a straight line, we define the rectilinear motion. Okay, fine. Now, what did I tell you? We are going to talk about displacement as well as the distance. Let us talk about that. Now, how am I going to take this distance as well as the displacement? Let me give you an example as which is given in your textbook. That is, let A, B and C. Let A, B and C represent the point of an object at different instant, and at the first the object moves through C and B and reaches A. Then it moves back along the same direction and reaches the path C through B. I'll write the question on the board. I'll define you the distance and explain you this one. Let A, B and C
represent the position of the object. Please do adjust with my handwriting, children. The notes will be given, no, do not worry, but understand the topic. That is very Let us continue. That let A, B and C represents the position of an object at different instants. At first, the object moves through C and B and reaches A. Then it moves back along the same path and reaches C through B. Now, they have given me an example, but I do not know in which direction it is moving. Initially, I'll take only the distance of the object from where it is moving and from where it has been stopped, and then after that I'll be seeing about the displacement. Now I wanted to see the distance in the cells. I need to define distance, correct? If I'm talking about distance, I need to define distance. What is this distance? The distance of an object is defined as the total path covered by an object from one point to the another point. Total distance covered by an object from one part to the another point. So it is total distance covered from one point to another. One point to another. It is the total distance covered from one point to the another with respect to time. Okay. Now, I do not know from which position to which position it has been. So, they have given me a diagram. That is, you will be having a ray where this is O, which has been starting from 0 and it's in difference of 5 till 60. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60. So, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, and 60. So, this is the ray or the direction of a straight line what it has been given. Then where is the point C? The point C is in the 25th position. Point B is in the 35th position. And point A is in the 60th position. And they have told we are going to talk in terms of kilometers. We are going to talk in terms of kilometers. Now what is this O? O is an object. O is an object. Now, what are we going to talk about? We are going to talk about the distance, that is total distance covered from one point to the another. Total distance. And the inhale, total distance, that is from your home to the school, back from school to the home. Artha aagta idya? And the, you know, maneli. From your home to the school, it is 1 kilometer and you will be back to the home after the school leaves. That is also 1 kilometer. So, what is the total distance you have traveled? 1 plus 1, it is 2 kilometers. Per day you are going to travel 2 kilometers. I do not want a distance. I do not want the direction in which way you have gone. No, I do not want. But I want you to meet from one point to the other point and you are going to calculate the total distance of the travel. Now, let A, B and C represents the position. Okay? A, B and C represents the position. Okay, fine. Then, of an object at different instants. So, different instants, that is the different points are there, they are going to be represented. At first, the object moves through C. So, the object is moving from O to C. So, what is the distance from O to C? From O to C, what is the distance? From O to C. That is OC. What is the distance, children? What is the distance of C? It is 25 kilometer. Okay, fine. Then after that, and B, that is the object is moving through C and B. So object to C atra hoito. For example, let me tell you, this is you. Okay, this is yourself. This is you. This is your first friend. This is your second friend. And this is your third friend. Okay, now from your home, you are going to reach your first friend. Your first friend, from your home to your first friend home, it is 25 kilometers. Okay, and you and your friend will go to the second friend house. Yerane friend house, so what is the distance? What is the total distance you have traveled from your home to the friend's home? That is second friend home. It is 35 kilometers. Total distance bekunange. Ilinda illigalla. No. Total distance is what? 35. So now where are you? You are at point B. So point B alli, what is the total distance you have traveled from your home to the second friend house? That is 35 kilometer. Now, second friend you got, and now you wanted to go to the third friend house. So what is the distance from your home to the third friend's house? It is 60 kilometers. So what is the total distance you have traveled? It is 60 kilometers. Artha astadiya, I do not want at which point you are stopped and from which point hogidira anta nanu beda nane beda. Now I want you total like eshtu path, eshtu distance cover madida. What is the total distance you have covered? So what is the total distance you have covered? It is 60 kilometers. Where are you now? From your home, you are at point A. That is OA. What is the distance of OA? It is 60 kilometers. This is morning routine. Now, you have traveled 60 kilometers. That is morning routine. Okay, fine. Now you are at point A. Then what they say? Then it moves back. Then you are going to move back along the same path. You turn the gondo matte ade pathal bartajira and reach C through B. So you are going to come to B and then reach C. And then you know, Mojana friends, you went and met your third friend. Okay. Then you did a party and all, you enjoyed over. Your third friend stay there itself. You are going to come back to your second friend house to live your second friend. Okay. Then after that, you come to your first friend house to live your first friend. To live your first friend. So what is the distance you have traveled from your third friend to the first friend house? It is 60 minus 25. How much is it? 35 kilometers. Calculate. 60 was the friend's house. You have come back. Vapas bandidira. Vapas bandidini antandre, you need to subtract. So that is, what is the C value? 25. When you subtract it, it becomes 5. And it is 35. So where are you now? You are at C. That is, from your home, you have come to C, OC, which is 35 kilometers. So, what is the total distance you have traveled? That is 95 kilometers you have traveled. How are you going to find out total? And then, you are going to add. You are going to add OA and OC. If you add OA and OC, you get 95 kilometers. I hope you understood. I'll explain it to you once again. Now, what is the thing is, same path ali vapas bartha idivi andre, you are going to subtract from the path where you are there. Neev ellidira a path inda where you are going to reach that path. You are going to subtract those two. Okay. Why you did not subtract while going? Cab hogbek ade subtract ma, why you did not go? You are going, you are not reached the end. Ninnu school reach agila subtract madadike. Correct? You are still moving. You are in motion. So here we added all. We got to know that you have traveled 60 kilometers in the first. That is morning routine. Now you are going to come back. When you are going to come back, you are at point C. That your mom has informed you. You are going to stay in your C friend house itself because I'll come and pick you up. So where are you now? You are in point C. Where was you initially? You were in point A. So what is the distance from point A to point C? if you want to calculate in a sense from point A to point C in a reverse order, then you are going to subtract. And when you are going to subtract, 60 minus 25, you will get 35. So what is the distance traveled totally? You have traveled 95 kilometers. Did you understand? Is distance topic understood to you? So let me end till the distance topic. I do not want you to get confused with the displacement. Displacement is the reverse of the distance. Now fix in your mind the distance topic. Okay. In the next class, we'll talk about displacement and the next topic. That is uniform motion and non-uniform motion. Now, did you find anything difficult in this? I hope you did not find any difficult thing in this. So, how are you going to say distance is a vector quantity? I did not think about the direction. I took only the total distance I've traveled. So, that distance is always a scalar quantity. Why I want the total distance? It's to travel maadidini anna deku. That is in kilometers. Okay? Okay, in meters form. I do not want it to be in the direction form. Oh, hingo the hing bande? No. You went and you are coming back in the same path. When you are coming back, then you are going to subtract it. That's it. Okay. Or, ma'am, I cannot understand, ma'am. You are making me very confusing. Okay, fine. If it is confusing, what is the thing they have told? Then it moves back along the same path and reach C. Through which point? Through B. So, you are going to come back in the same path. You are at B and you will be coming back to point C. So, what is the distance of B? What is the distance of B? It is 35. You can write 35 as it is. Ma'am, I cannot understand why you have subtracted. Okay, fine. If you do not understand, where are you need to go? From where? From point. Sorry. You are going to reach C through which point? Through B point. So, what is the distance of B? 35. You are going to reach point O from through point C. So, what is the distance of point C? It is 25. So, what is the distance you will write here? 25. Understood? When you are not able to subtract, when you are getting confused to subtract, then you can say through which point? Through which point? Through B. So, what is the value of B? It is 25. If I say through C, what is the distance here? C, 25. Through O, what is the distance of O? 0. Like that, you are going to calculate. Understood? Yeah, thank you very much, children. The notes will be uploaded. Please do copy the notes and prepare for your test. Okay, till the end, how much ever the notes and the video comes, till there, you can copy it down and be prepared for your test. Thank you.